You might hear peroxisome biogenesis disorder, Zellweger spectrum disorder, referred to by other names, including Zellweger syndrome, neonatal adrenoleukodystrophy, infantile Refsum disease, and Heimler syndrome. In recent years, these four disorders that were formerly grouped into separate diseases are now known to be a continuum or spectrum disease with varying degrees of severity. We now know the genetic basis for these disorders are all the same genes, and each child just presents a little differently, even though they may have very, very similar gene mutations.
In the 1950s, a group of disorder was described by this pediatrician, Dr. Hans Zellweger. He was calling this syndrome the cerebrohepatorenal syndrome at that time. And a couple of years later, it was actually discovered that it was a problem of peroxisomes, which was not known before. But really, in the last 5 years, we decided as the group of scientists to call this group of disorders Zellweger spectrum disorders, and we dropped the name Zellweger syndrome, neonatal adrenoleukodystrophy, and infantile Refsum disease, and we rather call them today, severe ZSD, Zellweger spectrum disorder, or intermediate or mild, all of this in the same spectrum. Changing the nomenclature for naming this disease, I think, was beneficial for, first of all, the families and the community to better understand that it's a peroxisome disorders, whatever diagnosis they got in this spectrum. And also, on the other hand, I think it helps clinicians and healthcare professionals to understand that having a ZSD doesn't necessarily mean you have the Zellweger syndrome, which is the more severe form. And sometimes one of the problems that the families ran into is that the first diagnosis that they got was Zellweger syndrome, and then the genetic counselor or the person who was taking care of them was telling them, well, Zellweger syndrome, we know that usually lifespan is below 1 year old, so you have to think about palliative care and things like that, which is actually not true at all, because if you look at the whole spectrum, you have, you know, more intermediate and milder children.
Visit our website, thegfpd.org, for more information about peroxisomal disorders and the mission of the Global Foundation for Peroxisomal Disorders.